Two-point perspective sounds hard and complicated, but we'll show you how to do it easily, and we'll also show you how to shade your objects to make your drawings even more realistic.
Welcome back to Linescapes, the fifth video of Basics of Drawing series, where we're gonna discuss two-point perspective.
And if you're new to the series, make sure you check out our previous videos that build up all the way to this one. We'll leave the links in the description below.
We're curious about your thoughts, what you've learned, and do you notice any progress? What topic would you like us to cover in the future videos? Leave us a comment below.
And if you don't want to miss any of the future ones and want to keep on learning how to draw, be sure to subscribe.
With a bell.
Always with a bell. Today we're going to look at a drawing tool called two-point perspective and show you how you can use it in your drawings. We're going to look at how to draw objects that are not frontal but standing sideways facing you with one edge.
The two-point perspective is basically the same one as one-point perspective, only that not all lines of an observed view are parallel. That's why we have more vanishing points than one, in our case two. We're going to need some space for this one, so you can use two pages if you have a small sketchbook. We'll draw a cube in perspective and also look at how to properly draw a shadow and a shade. Start by drawing a horizon somewhere on the middle of your page. Now let's pick two vanishing points. One more toward the middle and one on the edge of the page on the other side. Next, we'll draw the edge of the cube that's facing us. At this point, it's just a vertical line. Now, connect the end point of the vertical line and the vanishing points with construction lines. To make this look like a cube, we need to draw the sides of the cube. Do this by defining the left and the right edge of the cube with two vertical lines. When determining how far from the original edge they should be, just use your feeling and draw them where they seem right. Now, connect the end point of the vertical line and the vanishing points with construction lines. Where the construction lines intersect is the fourth edge of the cube that's facing away from us. It's starting to look like a cube, right? You can retrace the cube with thicker lines to make it stand out more. But we're not quite finished yet. We want to draw a proper shadow for this cube because, you know how they say, every cube needs its shadow. This will also give the drawing an even stronger feeling of space. Okay, let's do it. It's a bit tricky, so pause at any point or rewind if you need to look closer. But I'll take you through it step by step. Our first step is to determine where the light source stands. Pick a point below the horizon. That's the foot of our light source. We also need to determine the actual point of the light source. So draw a vertical line from the foot point all the way up to the horizon, almost to the edge. This is where our light will be coming from. To construct the shadow the cube is casting, we'll need some more construction lines. So let's make an exception today and use the ruler, since the lines are really fine and need to be precise. Draw a thin line from the foot of the light source toward the bottom of the cube edge, facing away from the light and extend beyond them. Do this also for the back edge, the one facing away from us. Do the same thing with the point of the light source and the tops of all three cube edges on the other side of the light source. Now look for points where construction lines going through the top and the bottom of the single cube edge intersect. There should be three of them, one for each edge. Still with me? Connect these three points with each other with straight lines. Then connect the bottom point and the top point with the bottom of the edges they originate from. Congratulations! This is the outline of the cast shadow. What's left now is to color it. First, I'll start with the shade. You can fill it with a color or a hatch. Now you can color in the shadow inside of the outlines we just constructed. Remember one important thing. the shadow is always darker than the shade. There we have it, a shaded cube in a two-point perspective. You can congratulate yourself, if you've been drawing this with me, of course.
Alright, so this is it.
And before we finish, we have one more important thing. We have an exercise for you that you can do until next week to improve your perspective drawing skills. So stick with us. We're also very curious how you're progressing with your work. So if you upload your work to Instagram and put a hashtag on it, LionsCakesBasics, then we'll definitely check it out and give you some further tips.
For those of you who want something extra, we have a challenge. If you have any questions about the task, feel free to always ask us in the comments. Similarly as before, we'll draw an object in a two-point perspective and then construct a cast shadow for it. Only this time we'll take a slightly more complex object. We'll draw a flat rectangle and another rectangle standing on top of it. Always start with the edge facing you. This will determine the height of the object and then proceed with connecting its point with the vanishing points. I know it's a challenge, but I think you're ready for the task. When you've constructed the bottom rectangle, you can proceed with the top one. Draw a vertical line extending from its side. This is going to be the first edge of its standing rectangle. Once the two rectangles are done, you can construct a shadow for them in the same way we did with the cube. When doing this, we'll treat both objects as one single object. Determine the foot of the light source and the top of it. Draw construction lines from the foot through the bottom of the object edges and from the top of the light source through the tops of the object edges. You should get 4 points where the construction lines going through each single edge cross. Connect those points and then connect the end points with the bottoms of the closest object edges. To finish off, fill in the shade and the shadow. And remember, the shadow is always darker than the shade.
You know what to do. Keep on drawing and see you next time.
With hashtag basics of drawing. No, LionsCakesBasics. Yeah.
LionsCakesBasics. Hashtag LionsCakesBasics.